السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We're still with obviously the history of the Khulafa and the meaning, the literal meaning of Khilafa, the literal meaning of the Khilafa and the job of the Khalifa. What is that definition of Khilafa and what's the definition of Khalifa Rashid? And Alhamdulillah that this is the book that we are covering because the Nubu'ah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the Khilafa in accordance to the Nubu'ah or the Manhaj of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is definitely going to happen. And it will obviously come from a masjid. It's not going to come from a stadium. It's not going to happen, you know, from a secular school. This is going to happen in or from a masjid. So we make dua that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us, if not those who will have this prophecy, at least try. And you never know, right? So the job of the Khilafa or the Khalifa, as Abu Bakr, well, first the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Banu Israel كانت تسوسوم الأنبياء, right? So the nations before us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa azza wa jal will send a prophet to manage and lead their lively matters via or through the religion or the deen or the manhaj that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jalla sends this prophet with. That prophet will die, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jalla will have another prophet immediately. So there was no gap between prophets in the previous Banu Israel. There is always a prophet that will lead and manage the lively affairs with the manhaj of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa ta'ala. Now, the unique fact about this ummah is that there is no nations after it. This is the last ummah. And why is it is the last ummah? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final prophet. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as the Khalifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fulfilled the mission, and then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away. So what happens to the deen of Allah since there are no other prophets coming? Does the deen get lost and then we just go astray? Of course not. And that is the uniqueness of this ummah, and that's the unique fact about you and I. That's the unique fact about the Muslims in this ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we follow the ulama, right? And who are the most knowledgeable of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The Sahaba, of course. And who amongst the Sahaba are the most knowledgeable about the deen and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Are the Khulafa al-Rashidin. Right? So, Al-Khalifa al-Rashid, the righteously guided successor of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the one who investigates and exhausts every single possible effort to meet the hukm that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have done or wanted to arrive to, following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even if this ijtihad does not end with that same exact result, that person is considered still a Rashid just by this intent, by this ijtihad that he is following the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the Prophet, so the successor or the Khalifa is the one who يفعل فعل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الأمة. However, obviously without the wahi, and that's why you hear many times that people will say Umar ibn Abdul Aziz رضي الله عنه is considered a Khalifa Rashid, even though Umar ibn Abdul Aziz رضي الله عنه led a huge empire. And for such a short time, he was only a Khalifa for just 2 years. But yet, many would consider him or would refer to him as a Khalifa Rashid. Why? Because he broadcasted, he أعلن للأمة, he declared this fact that ما من قضية صغيرة أو كبيرة تعرض علي إلا أجتهد كل اجتهاد في أن أصيب حكم الله فيها. That there is and this was the declaration that he رضي الله عنه did رحمه الله, right? That he declared that there is no matter that would be given to me except that I will do every effort to do or follow the footsteps of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to arrive to that hukm that he صلى الله عليه وسلم would have wanted to arrive to. Not only that, and if I do arrive to this hukm, I will fulfill it. I will do it, even if it costs my own life or my household's life, right? And obviously the pinnacle of khilafa is Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, the Khalifa of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this example or this statement that we're going to cover right now makes this understanding really come alive, is when he told Umar radiallahu anhu, أجبارٌ في الجاهلية خوارٌ في الإسلام يا عمر. When Umar radiallahu anhu was, you know, talking with Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu about, you know, the don't fight the ridda, those who did not want to pay the zakat. That look, we have so many other major fronts to, you know, to fight. Then let's, they are still, they say la ilaha illallah, they say, right? Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, wallahi, he swore radiallahu anhu, لو منعوني عناق بعير جاهدتهم علي. That if they were to try not to give me a rope of a little camel, just the rope, if this was something due to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or to the deen, and they tried to not give that, I would fight for it. So the job of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to complete the deen. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu did that same exact, he fulfilled this mission that had he sallallahu alayhi wasallam was still alive, he would have done that, right? So that is the succession of the person who's been appointed by by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he radiallahu an, Abu Bakr radiallahu an said, أَيَنْقُصُ الدِّينُ وَأَنَا حَيٍّ. Do you expect that I would while I'm alive, this deen would be reduced in any way? Anything that in this deen would be changed while I'm alive? That's what I'm living for, right? That's the mentality of al-khilafa al-rashida. So this al-khilafa al-rashida is not some, you know, vague pie in the sky somewhere with, no, this is something that you and I are to strive to do. It's simply that spirit. That أَيَنْقُصُ الدِّينُ وَأَنَا حَيٍّ. How could you imagine that this deen could be changed or could be attacked or could be reduced while I am alive? So this is the job of the Khalifa. And that's it for this evening, inshallah. We're not gonna see you for 2 weeks, but inshallah, when we come back, we'll resume, inshallah. So, inshallah, in these 2 weeks, we try and work on that. الله يحفظكم جزاكم الله خيرا سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.